So the other day, I made a video breaking down my entire process on how I'm getting, you know, sharp photos and videos with the Sony APS-C cameras. Now, in that particular video, I was, you know, mainly focusing on the camera settings and the post-process, you know, editing. And, you know, in retrospect, I realized that I totally forgot to mention what is a very important aspect if you want that sharpness, you know? So, my friends, in today's video, we are going to talk about just that. Yo, karla frétta, my name is Arnoldur and I'm a photographer from Iceland. So, the subject of today's video is going to be the importance of choosing, you know, a good lens. Many people, you know, even go that far saying that is the most important thing. Now, I'm not totally sure if I, like, completely agree with that sentence. It's a bold sentence, you know. The camera body definitely plays, you know, a huge part. It's where the sensor sits and you get the megapixels and a bunch of other good stuff. However, I do though believe that it's very important, and comparing a good lens with a bad body, it's definitely way better than comparing, you know, a bad lens with a good camera body. Plus, you know, the lens is a better investment. We'll touch more on that in a second. The lens delivers your scene to the sensor and enables you to play with the focus and the depth of field. They also vary in sharpness, and if you get a good lens, they can deliver, you know, some amazing footage. I'm currently filming this video right here on the Sigma 60mm, and it's known, you know, for being super sharp. And you can, like, see this video is sharp. I'm sharp. Now, if you think about it, the lens is, you know, the first thing your image goes through before it goes to your sensor in your camera body. So, you know, having a bad lens and then you put it on an amazing camera body, it's probably not going to yield you the best result. Because your image will then, you know, first go through a bad lens and then it's going to go, like, into the camera body. And, you know, it's not gonna be as nice. It's the same reason why you don't wanna put, like, bad filters on amazing lenses, because then, you know, the first thing the image will go through is the bad filter and it will skew up your image. But, you know, an amazing lens will capture, you know, some amazing footage. Another thing that I think is, like, cool to consider is that different lenses will give you, you know, different look. And I'm not just talking about, you know, the focal length and all that, but also, like, the characteristics of the look that you're getting. So sometimes when I'm, like, want to get, like, a specific look, I usually start with the lens, you know. Now, don't twist my words here. I am totally not saying that the camera doesn't matter. In fact, you know, it matters greatly. The camera body, you know, it sets the correct timing and other parameters, and it provides the sensor to accurately generate a precise file from the optical input. It's also, you know, where you get all those megapixels that we photographers are always obsessing about. Magnús, hvað finnst þér megapixla? So, you know, both the camera body and the lens matters a great deal, and they work in, you know, harmony with each other. Wasn't this beautiful? It's like poetry. Harmony with each other. And if you're aiming for, you know, the best possible result, you of course want to get, like, a fantastic lens and a fantastic body, and they're gonna work in harmony with each other. Say it again with me and rolling the R's. Harmony. How would you say in English? Harmony. The harmony. Do it with the harmony. See, I can't do it without rolling it. However, with all that, you know, being said, in my opinion, if you can only choose between either one of those, going with a good lens is definitely the wiser choice. Because, you know, as we've talked about, it will give you better result. Plus, there is another thing I think is, like, very, like, worth to mention. It's also a better investment. Let me explain. In my opinion, in regards, you know, to financial investment, a good lens is the better choice because it will last you much longer than the body. You know, you'll generally be changing camera bodies faster than you will be changing your lenses. Camera manufacturers are constantly, you know, coming up with new cameras and making them as awesome as possible. And today, as of, you know, 2020, I think that, like, all cameras are awesome. They're very, very good. So what camera should you choose? Choose whatever, you know, they are good. But, you know, lenses, they tend to develop at a slower pace, and a good lens is a good lens. I own a very old lens that is from the Soviet Union. Like, that empire fell before I was even born. I think this lens is, like, it's old, okay? And it's still good. I mean, it's not as sharp as today's lenses, but it has some amazing characteristics that are super much like a swirly bokeh and very, very, very fun to use. Like, bottom line is, I can still use it, you know.
Now, I'm not totally sure, like, about what I'm going to say in the next sentence, because I'm not a lens manufacturer, but to me, it kind of feels, you know, like it's harder to innovate on the lens front than it is, you know, on the cameras. It's like, once you've made a good and a sharp lens, it will stay good and sharp.
Also, a fun thing to consider is that the lens will open up the doors for you to create the images, the photos or videos that you dream of making.
All right, so bottom line, you know, of this entire video that we've been enjoying here together, me and you, maybe you're two of you, maybe there are three of you, but it, at least all of us have had a good time.
Sometimes it feels like I'm hypnosing. I'm like, hey, it's been a good time, right? Good time, and smack that like button, smack that like button, look into my eyes, smack that like button.
That was a massive sidetrack. Anyways, the bottom line of this entire video is that if you want to get like sharp videos or footage, my recommendation is that you start by getting yourself a good lens. It's also a good investment, you know, sort of, because you'll definitely own and use that lens way after you've updated your camera bodies, maybe even, you know, several times.
So that brings us to the end of the video where I used to say this.
Anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, as always, you know, feel free to ask in comments down below. If you, you know, could smack that like button for me, it really help me out. I know I already said that, but you know, it doesn't hurt to say it again. Also, if you could, you know, smack. I said that. I'm not going to say it three times. What I was supposed to say is also, if you, you know, consider subscribing, because I create bunch of videos and it'll make me very, very happy. And making, you know, an Icelander happy brings good luck. And last but not least, you know, your support really means the world to me. And I like highly appreciate that you're still here watching. Thank you. You're a total legend. I will catch you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace.